From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
And I'm Arun O'Valley. Shrimp fishermen are calling it bad science, but regulators say that the new catch limits are necessary to preserve the shrimp population in the Gulf of Maine.
And they're going to face off at a meeting in South Portland today. News 8's Tama Ponton tells us how these new regulations could affect shrimp fishermen.
Shrimpers say the study that led to the reduction is called the Colley-Sisson-Wine analysis, and it shows an alarming reduction in shrimp stocks. But shrimpers say it grossly underestimates the size of the shrimp population. Now, shrimpers say the 2012 season, which started back on January 2nd, could be the shortest in years if regulators decide to limit the catch to 4.4 million pounds. That is down from 13 million last year. Now, shrimpers are asking the public to sign an online petition to save their season. And at today's meeting with regulators, they plan to present an alternative shrimp stock assessment. Now, today's meeting is scheduled for 9:30 at Sable Oaks in South Portland, and we will keep you updated on what happens on our website, WMTW.com, and later today on News 8. From the waterfront in Portland, I'm Tama Ponton, News 8 Now.
Police in Bath asking for your help in the investigation of a man whose body was found at a local hotel. Police say they found the body of 35-year-old Sean Duffy in a room at the Hampton Inn last Saturday. They said the preliminary cause of death, it's an overdose of illegally obtained prescription drugs. Police interviewing people who were with him shortly before his death. In fact, investigators looking for this man, 31-year-old Mark Waltris. They say they want to question him about events leading up to Duffy's death. If you know where he is, you are asked to contact Bath Police.
Today, jury selection is expected to begin for the trial of an Ellsworth High School custodian accused of dealing drugs to students. Frank Trundy was arrested back in October on felony aggravated drug trafficking charges. The Maine Drug Enforcement Agency says Trundy sold two different types of prescription painkillers. Police say they busted him in October when an undercover officer posing as a new custodian bought some codeine tablets from him. Also, a man from North Yarmouth expected to in court to change his plea. Michael Marston, accused of sexually assaulting a girl under the age of 14. He's being charged with felony sexual assault. Cumberland County Sheriff's deputies arrested Marston back in October, and they would not say exactly what happened, but he was released from the Cumberland County Jail on bail the very next day.
York County commissioners have decided they will not fund the York County Food Pantry for the second year in a row. Commissioners cut funding to several social service programs because of a tight budget. Last night, about 50 people showed up to the budget meeting to protest the decision. Food pantry workers say they now have to ask for money from individual towns and cities and not from the county. They say that's difficult, especially with so many people in need.
The food pantry is serving double of what the numbers of last year, and having this lack of the $31,000 has really been critical for our operations.
Now, at the meeting, there were a couple of people who supported the county commissioners, and they say taxpayers should not have to fund charities.
Well, thanks for tuning into this News 8 Now update. I'm Erin O'Valley.
And I'm Shanna Moss. Stay with us. We're going to bring the latest forecasts and sports highlights in just a few minutes. We'll be right back.